Hey guys, what's up? I'm back again with another video for you. Today, I'm going to be going over the pros and cons of the new MacBook Pro. Hey guys, let's get into it. Today I want to show off my new 13-inch MacBook Pro. I'm going to go over some pros and cons about what I think about the MacBook Pro. Now keep in mind, I haven't had a MacBook for about 10-15 years. In fact, I've never had a MacBook at all. I use the iMac. It's been a really long time I've been using that computer. It's lasted me forever, but recently I realized that I need a new computer because it was just really slow and just it wasn't updating. So I decided to go for the new MacBook Pro 13-inch, 16 GB RAM, 256 GB of storage. Now this is gonna cost you a pretty penny. It's actually quite expensive to upgrade your Mac. So the more stuff you want, if you don't want the base model, you're gonna have to pay for it. So it does get a little pricey, but keep in mind, most of it is worth it. So here's a couple pro things I like about this thing. The first thing I realized is how light it is. It's so light, it's so thin, I can barely feel it when I lift it. It's so light. So if you're the type of person that travels, if you're the type of person that wants to work on the go, this is a perfect computer for you. You can barely feel how heavy it is. It's nothing. It weighs nothing. The other thing is they upgraded the keyboard. So the butterfly keys are a thing of the past. You actually have a nice magic keyboard. Kind of reminds me of the one I use for my iMac, except thinner, and it is so nice and quiet. You can not hear a thing when you're typing. It's so soft and light. This whole thing is such an amazing experience, and changing the keyboard just enhanced that. The visual on this thing is really, really good as well. Even though my old Mac was a bit weird when it came to the visuals, because it's so old, I actually didn't really notice that it was not that great. Opening up a brand new MacBook is just a treat. Like, it is crisp, the screen, the colors. So that's a really big plus for this. So if you're a person who does video editing, animation, Photoshop, things like that, you want a crisp screen, this is the one for you. Now you can get the 13-inch or the 16-inch. A lot of people are debating whether you should get the 16 versus the 13 because it's a bigger screen. I actually don't mind the 13-inch. I thought it was gonna be a little bit annoying to have it smaller and I didn't wanna spend the extra money, but this is actually not too bad. It's really, really cool because if you need more space and you kinda wish you got a bigger screen, you can actually hook it up to your old MacBook or your iPad and use that as a second screen using an app called Sidecar. One of the other things I really like about this Mac is that it's extremely quiet as well. You actually don't hear it at all. You don't hear any fans, even though it has two fans inside here. It stays kind of cool. You do feel a little bit of heat, but it's really, really quiet. You can put it anywhere and not even know it's on. Another cool thing is the touch bar. Now, this isn't a new feature by any means, but it's actually very useful in some apps that actually take advantage of it. So, for example, in YouTube, you can actually use it to scroll through your video. In Final Cut Pro, you can use it for the timeline. There's so many cool things you can do with it. I really think it's a cool feature, and it actually saves from having all these buttons everywhere, so the keyboard can be much smaller. So, good on you, Apple, for putting in that touch bar. As far as the cons, the only couple of things I can think of is the USB ports are non-existent. There's no more USB. You get the lightning cable thing. You have to get a dongle in order to plug in your camera, your iPad, things like that. I ended up getting the cord that plugs in your iPad to the computer. So I got a new cord for that, but now I can't plug in my camera. So I've been Dropboxing everything or airdropping photos. And that's kind of a pain in the butt. So I did order a dongle. It was an extra 50 bucks. I got mine on Amazon. I'll tag it in the description below if you guys wanna check it out. I mean, it's a minor issue, but you can kind of see the money grab in all of this. And that's just one thing I was kind of upset about. Another thing that I could live with, but it is kind of annoying, is the touch bar's ability to kind of get accidentally hit. So sometimes I'm typing on it and accidentally hit the volume button and all of a sudden everything's muted, or you know, I'm accidentally touched the brightness. It's so sensitive that without turning it off or moving the apps around, sometimes I actually hit it when I'm typing. Maybe that's just the way I type. Maybe I'm messing up, so it's not really a con per se, but it is one thing that's super annoying when it comes to the touch bar. Anyway, I hope you guys really enjoyed this video of the pros and cons to the MacBook Pro 2020 13-inch. If you guys enjoyed this video, I really, really would appreciate even a like. throw a like, that helps me. If you really want to get freaky, hit that subscribe button because you don't want to miss my new video content. Now that I have a Mac, I can make videos all the time and the quality has raised up. So I'm telling you guys, if you want to stay in touch, either turn on your notifications or subscribe. Anyway, go buy yourself that MacBook Pro that you've always wanted. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.